How we doing there, folks? God, blimey, this is the earliest I've actually been up for bloody years. So I work 2 to 10. Been doing that for over 6 years now. So getting up this early is a bit of a challenge for me. Welcome back, folks. Thank you very much for the support on the Dover Castle video. Yeah, that was overwhelming. So yes, I will definitely be doing videos of Dover Castle, so I better be checking into the history books and start researching. So every location I go to, I want to talk about the history of it as well, when it was built, all that style. But today, well, my shoes are soaked now as well. There's a lot of dew on the grass in the mornings down there. It's North Detached Bastion, I believe. Not North Centre Bastion. North Centre Bastion is the back one. That's Detached Bastion down there. I've got videos of that actually, if you check it out on the search. Or maybe actually click above here, you'd better see inside that place. So, yeah, I'm actually going up to the Citadel today. Do some drone shots while the weather's still good. And see if I've fixed the problem with the firmware. Because I wasn't getting over 50 metres. Of distance and height. It's a bit of a problem, that was. But yeah, you know, I found out probably about a month ago actually that they were knocking down a massive chimney in Grain, the old Grain power station chimney. It's the second tallest chimney in the UK, and they've blown it up yesterday, the 7th of September 2016. It's gone, folks. And I have got some video footage of it, because when I went to Grain to do the fort and the tower, I managed to get some drone footage of it. Oh, this is crazy. Of it before they blew it up. And this is before I knew they were going to blow it up anyway. So check this footage out. Yeah, so basically what I'm going to be filming with the drone today is the Citadel. This is a massive, one of the best, the heart of the Western Heights fortifications, a massive place. It was built in the Napoleonic Wars. It was used in the First and Second World War. From like the late 50s, used as a borstal, then it became a young offenders institution. And then it opened as a, what the hell, immigration centre. And I actually worked there for 4 years as a kitchen porter. Yes, an experience. I managed to get to see inside the tunnels, inside the Citadel. I was going to do the droning just here, but saw a couple of prison officers in the moat. It's not a prison anymore. The whole place is shut down now, but security is still there. Before it shut down, there was no go with drones over it. I don't want to risk it over there just in case the police are called, you know. So I'm going to go up this section and go from the back over. Have a little play with the drone from that end. Oh my God. Jesus. What are you? You're not going to attack me, folks, are you? Let's go through these things. They're all running. Can I get through? Don't know whether they're going to attack, do you? Hello, you're right. These ones are not moving. Oh God, don't kick, do they? Always makes me laugh as well. When I get to the point of where I want to set the drone off, it gets windier. But it's going up there. Well, look at the view. Do you know what I mean? We're in the open space here. I've got two batteries for the drone anyway, it's 40 minutes around. They're not cheap, I can say, folks. Bloody hell. Nearly as expensive as the bloody drone itself, these batteries. Give this a try so I'll be able to see the screen a bit better. Right, so that was a bit unsuccessful. We got a bit of a glimpse of it, so hope you enjoyed that, folks. But yeah, if you are a DJI Phantom user and you see the latest updates, the firmware updates, all the exciting stuff, it's probably best not to download it straight away. I'm looking for a way to backgrade back to the previous version. So I've got 120 meters with that thing, and here over 50, and I can't see nothing. I can still drive it, no problems there. It's just the image transmitting, it's gone. So when you was up there, we saw the Citadel, and over here we got the there's a gun battery, probably built from 1860 or something like that, proper derelict. Let's check this out. Done videos on this. If you click the link here, the card, it takes you to some older videos that I've done in 2014 that shows you inside the magazines. So check them out, folks. But yeah, I won't do much with this. I'll show you the aerial shots. Check this out. Bit cheesed off, really, with the old drone firmware update. We'll check all this out again another time. We'll do another video on that, a bit of history as well. But that's called the Citadel Battery. So, yeah, like I was saying about Dover Castle and that, it's not going to be every week up there. Now the winter's coming, they're going to be shutting the castle during the weekdays. And it's only going to be open on weekends, which is a bit unfortunate. But yeah, I will be going up there. But in the meantime, I'll be doing small videos like this of me sort of using the drone maybe over some historic sites or checking out a little site like that. It's not much of a checkout, but yeah, it's there. And that involves me getting up early during the week and going out and recording the vlog. But yeah, you can see the old buildings here, the Citadel. Yeah, because we've got tunnels in there, north casemates, tunnels behind there, the south casemates. And beneath this lot here, right here in front of me, there was a moat. The Western Outworks Defence Coupon here. That's now been buried. It's buried in the 60s, late 50s, early 60s. And it's still down there. There's a massive caponia, different rooms and stuff like that. Just like the same one as the one at Fort Burgoyne that you saw in the Dover Castle one, an aerial shot of it. I think that was built in the 1860s, so. Just saw someone go past, just walked past me just now. And shout out morning to him. And he was a bit like reluctant to say, hit back. It's a bit rude, but it's a bit of a mumble. There's a lot of miserable people out here, folks. A lot of miserable people. Well, I think that concludes today's video, folks. Thanks for the support. And we'll get round to those Dover Castle videos, definitely. Looking forward to them, actually. Check out Instagram, Facebook and all that jazz. Lots happening on Facebook. There's loads of people on there at the moment, posting stuff from all over the country. Let's check that out. Now I've got to go through these cows again. Oh, there's one there. Madness. I'll also do a video about my equipment, my camera, my lights. So I think there's a lot of people out there that I've motivated to go out exploring themselves. So I could tell you what equipment I use for lights and all that stuff. So I will do one of them as well. But on that note, folks, thanks very much. I'm going to go home and do some editing before I go to work. And yeah, see you soon. Cheers. So fuel for the planes would have been stored underneath this room in a bunker. Bomb-proof bunker. And you're actually wondering, where are the fuel tanks? Documenting stuff, I don't want to be smelling fire. You know, you do get idiots about that set fire to old buildings and stuff like that. I do not want to be around if people are doing that. So what do you reckon on this site then?
I think it's actually quite scary, to be honest with you. It's a bit creepy. Comparing it to Canterbury, when we went there to the psychiatric hospital.